to Prime News. Now look at the headlines. Test in GMC increased by 1,000 samples per day after Operation Raktacharitra. Test in microbiological lab increased by almost 100%. Congress leader Philip Neri gives consent to withdraw case against BJP leaders Satish Dhawan and Sadanand Tanawde in forged signature case. Six ferry ticket collectors and sailors caught in ferry ticket scam allege injustice, gets ITAC backing, captain of ports justifies their suspension. Government announces one-time grant of 5 lakh rupees for panchayats in mining belt. Bill giving more powers to panchayats in next assembly session. And Goa Police Department plans massive security exercise for January's Lusophonia Games. Flags will be allowed at games venues, clarifies CEO Keshav Chandra. And now the news in detail. It's prudent impact. After Operation Raktacharitra, the number of medical tests in the GMC have increased tremendously. Biochemistry lab itself has shown rise of around 1,000 patients per day, whereas microbiological lab records rise of 100% test in this week. This has revealed that every day around 1,000 tests were diverted to private path labs by flouting rules. It's Raktacharitra impact.
It's a prudent impact. Prudent conducted Operation Raktacharitra on 19 and 20th October. Operation exposed how a stranger, an agent of private patholabs, had made GMC wards his primary business. Prudent exposed how the agent, without any fear, exploited needy patients by taking out their blood samples for tests and made fortunes for himself and his godfathers. Now Prudent has accessed the figures which show how many patients were getting cheated and looted every day. Following are the statistics from biochemistry lab in GMC before and after Operation Raktacharitra. Biochemistry lab before sting operation: 2,400 tests recorded on 14th October, 2,600 on 15th October, 550 on 16th October, it was the Eid holiday, 2,420 on 17th October, and 2,500 tests recorded on 18th October in biochemistry lab. And after sting operation, 3,566 tests were recorded in biochemistry lab on 22nd October, 2,900 on 23rd October, and 3,400 on 24th October. The rise in the number of patients availing facility of medical tests has shot up by 1,000 per day after Operation Raktacharitra. This clearly shows that the samples were diverted to private labs before the sting operation. Now, microbiological lab before and after Operation Raktacharitra. Microbiological lab before sting operation: 40 tests were recorded on 14th October, 44 tests on 15th October, 16th October was the Eid holiday, 59 tests were recorded on 17th October, and 58 tests were recorded on 18th October. And after sting operation, microbiological lab recorded 84 tests on 21st October, 98 tests on 22nd October, 100 tests on 23rd October, and 90 tests were recorded on 24th October. These figures clearly shows the magnitude of wrongdoings in GMC. Around 1,000 to 1,500 patients were exploited all these months by the blood sample agent of private path labs in connivance with few GMC staff. Bureau Prudent.
Former Congress Minister Philip Neri has given his consent to withdraw forged signature case against BJP leaders Satish Dhawan and Sadanand Sheth Tanawde. Manohar Parrikar-led government had approached the court to withdraw the cases against its rulers. Court had asked for Philip Neri's opinion as he was the complainant. Philip Neri's consent has created ripples in the political circle in Goa.
Congress leader Philip Neri's signature forgery case involving BJP leaders Satish Dhon and Sadanand Tanawade will be counted as the most controversial and infamous cases in the political history of Goa. Philip Neri had charged that Satish Dhon and Tanawade forged his signature to disqualify him and save the BJP-led government in 2005. Later, he filed a police complaint alleging forgery. But now, Philip Neri's present stand has shocked politicos in the state. Government asked for permission from the court to withdraw case against Satish Dhon and Sadanand Sheth Tanawade. Court issues notice to Philip Neri Rodriguez as his complainant in the case. Philip Neri gives consent to the court to withdraw his case against Satish Dhon and Tanawade. Prudent contacted Philip Neri for his comments. He claims he had totally forgotten about this case as he had got justice thereafter. He even became a minister in the Digambar-led cabinet.
Judgment has actually no case. Court has not heard it. Government is interested to close down, but there is a clause of a judgment from Supreme Court. Such cases cannot be closed unless the complainant is heard.
Okay.
This is very clear. Master PD is demand sangle. To close government and Kurba Chelli, but thing is, I have to close the clan, put Saman Kala, otherwise, put Saman Kurba Goras Naslum. All these years, I was never called. And in the question of pursuing for the judgment, they right, because I was always relieved. When they heard me, I said, I got relief long back, 8 years back. I was requalified, and I have contested again, I lost. So, I said, I have no interest.
In pursuing that is the matter. Okay, so you have already withdrawn the
case. Definitely, no. It
is my conscious decision. And Vijay Sardesai have termed Philip Neri's consent as fixing between Congress and the RSS.
Was a minister, Jaka BJP Mandal deforestation minister. आणि हे एक आरएसएस प्रचाराचे केसच विड्रॉ केल्या म्हणून आणि आजो अर्थ अशी जाता की एक गोवा के लोक अजीब आहे म्हणतात ते खरेच अजीबच आहे आणि नवे एक तरेचे अजीब पण की काँग्रेस आणि आरएसएसचे भीतर एक पॅचअप दिसता एक केसीच्या एंडात.
नाव दिस हॅज एक्सपोज्ड द कॉन्स्पिरसी ऑफ द काँग्रेस विथ द बीजेपी अँड द आरएसएस to weaken our party president's position in the TV constituency. And therefore, NCP strongly condemns this act of the Congress, who should explain to the people of Goa as to when they have started having soft corner to RSS people.
Philip Neri was lifted from the assembly by marshals when he supported Congress-led government after withdrawing his support to Parrikar-led government. Later, Speaker disqualified Philip Neri, citing his BJP membership. Neri claims the membership form with his signatures was forged. Philip Neri had lodged a police complaint thereafter. Bureau Prudent.
The 6 ferry ticket collectors and sailors suspended by captain of boats have alleged injustice. ITEC has backed the aggrieved sailors. They claim that there is no irregularity on the part of sailors. However, captain of boats has maintained that the action is appropriate as the revenue collected from the commuters was not deposited.
There are almost 140 ticket collectors and sailors working on the state-run ferries across the state. Agitated sailors met the Joint Secretary of ITEC, Raju Mangeshkar, on Friday in Panaji. They complained that it is injustice on the fellow sailors who have been suspended by the captain of ports. Mangeshkar has backed the agitated sailors.
2011 च्या सुद्धा त्यांना रेकॉर्ड मिळाला. सगळे जे आज हंगा आले तिथले सेलर सांगता की आम्ही 2011 12 13 रेग्युलरली पैसे भरून रिवर नेव्हिगेशन डिपार्टमेंटला भरल्यात. त्यांना रिसिटी दिल्यात. आता डिपार्टमेंटचे काय लोक म्हणतात की त्यांच्याकडे बुक ना, ओरिजिनल बुक ना. ज्यांना रिसिट ओरिजिनली टीसिंग दिल्या, म्हणजे जे सेलर टीसीचे काम त्यांच्याकडे दिलं, त्यांना रिसिटी असतात. ऑल गॉट ओरिजिनल रिसिट गिवन टू देम कलेक्टेड आमच्या पैसे मिळाले म्हणून. पण आम्ही म्हणतात की कॅप्टनाने जे थोरं इन्व्हेस्टिगेशन करचे. आता 2011 जर पैसे भरना जाल्यार 3 वर्षां हांवें न्हिदलेले खंय. हे जे ऑफिसर जे वयले जे आसात जे फेल टू तेंची ड्यूटी करपा ते पयले सस्पेंड जावपाचो आमचो डिमांड आहा.
However, the captain of ports, James Braganza, says that action is appropriate and the things are getting in order now following the action.
So there are various sort of irregularities happening with all sorts of excuses. And that's the reason they're, until they pay all the dues to the government, they are under suspension.
What is the
receipt? Well, receipt is the receipt. They kept all this collected money with them for a long period of time. They are supposed to be periodically giving it to the government.
Earlier on Thursday, the captain of port suspended 6 ferry ticket collectors and the sailors for not depositing money collected by them from commuters since last couple of months. Omkar Falari for Prudent.
Chief Minister Manohar Parikar has announced 5 lakh rupees one-time grant to 35 panchayats in mining belt by 19 December. Government is considering giving more powers to the panchayats and the bill is expected in the next assembly session. He was speaking at the concluding function of Golden Jubilee celebrations of Panchayati Raj.
मायनींग सेक्टरांतले कोण जे पंचायती आसा आतां मेनी ऑफ देम हॅव इनकम तांचे एकदम झिरोचेर आयल्या शुन्य जाल्ल्या थोड्या पंचायतीचे ते आयडेंटिफाय करून 19 डिसेंबरा पर्यंत तांच्यांनी प्रत्येकाक 5 लाख एज अ वन टायम ग्रांट दिवची ही घोशणा केल्या ती कंप्लीट अप्लाय करची. हांव इतलेंच सांगूं सोदता की हें सरकार पंचायत आनी जिल्ला पंचायतीक चडांत चड अधिकार दिवपाक सोदता. पंचायती ह्यो सेल्फ फायनान्सींग सेल्फ इंडिपेंडंट आनी जर इंडिपेंडंट जाले ना जाल्यार एका विशिश्ट पर्संटेजीन सरकाराचो रेवेन्यू पंचायतीक वचूंक जाय हाज्या बद्दल आमकां मातूय म्हाका मातूय येता दुबाव ना. बट दे शूड ऑल्सो नॉट बिकम अनएकाउंटेबल म्हणजे जबाबदारी दिता येणाऱ्या कांय दिसांनी आमी एक्सरसायज करतले वी वील गीव ऑल रिसिपियंट पावर्स पावर्स दिता आमी डेफिनेटली दिता बट पावर्सा बरोबर अकाउंटेबिलिटी आसूंक जाय.
स्पीकर राजेंद्र आलेकर, पंचायत मिनिस्टर लक्ष्मीकांत पार्सेकर, एमपी श्रीपाद नाईक, बीजेपी एमएलएज, जिल्हा पंचायत मेंबर्स एंड अदर्स वर प्रेझेंट एट द फंक्शन. यंग मेंबर्स ऑफ पंचायत वर फेलिसिटेटेड ऑन द ओकेजन.
बजेट हे पंचायतीच्या बाबतीत महत्वाची गोष्ट असता. ते वेळार बजेट तयार झाले की ना, ते कायद्याप्रमाणे केला की ना, बजेट तयार केले आणि एक्सपेंडिचर बजेटा भायर झालं असे सांगणार, बजेट तयार केल्या प्रमाणेच खर्च झाला की ना.
सिनियर व्हिडिओ जर्नलिस्ट तुळशीदास चारी फॉर प्रुडंट.
इट्स टाइम फॉर अ शॉर्ट ब्रेक, स्टे ट्यून्ड.